To demonstrate how to add element references, let me go ahead and delete these element references I created earlier. Now when you do this, you're going to have to be careful that you delete the reference, not the actual element. So I'll choose Delete Reference, and that way the element itself stays in its original place. I'll go ahead and delete the references to it, and I'll check this in. Now if you recall earlier, I had created element references by just drag and drop, and we will cover that in just a second. But normally what you would do, or another way to do this, is to do a right click on this element right here, because this is where we want the element reference, and I'm going to choose New, and then choose Add an Element Reference. This is not a new element, this is just a reference to an existing element. So I'll go ahead and browse for that. And it's under Plant A, Area 1, this line A, there's my reference right there. And when I go ahead and click on OK, it will go ahead and add a, this is going to be a reference type parent-child to that, that heat exchanger. And there we see it showing up there. Now, I could have done that multiple, or both of them at once. Let me go ahead and undo what I just did. And let me show you how we could have done this again. New, add element reference. If I chose multiple, then I get a search screen. And from the search screen, I can go out and find the exchanger. So I'm just going to type in some keywords, ch for exchanger. Go out and search. And let's see, what did we choose? Sub-elements? Yeah. I think we need to put in an asterisk for search criteria. There we go. I forgot the asterisk, the wild card. And now it gave us one that we didn't want, so I'm going to ignore that. But here's my heat exchanger A and B. And I'm going to define both of those as parent-child. So there we go. Now we've made that reference. I can go ahead and check that in. And now we have our element references. These element references are showing up as parent-child element references. Now if you go out to this section right here, child elements, there is an option here to show these grouped by reference type. So as you can see, parent-child is showing up here. If I had others that were either composition or weak, we should see those in another category there. Well, let me make this a little bit more like what our exercise was, or our example was. If you remember in my example, I suggested it might be useful sometime to make this a strong reference, the strong reference between heat exchangers and these two here, but then make this a weak reference. So how would I go about changing those references right now, or just kind of reorganizing these references to fit this model? Now let me go back and demonstrate. Yeah, first let's take a look at what we have now. Compare that to what we want. Now, right now, if I look at this and categorize this by reference type, I can see that this is a parent-child reference here. So heat exchanger A and B, they're actually okay at this point. I've made these strong references to the parent, and that's what we wanted. This, on the other hand, if I look at line A, this is currently set up with a parent-child relationship, and I didn't want that. I wanted a weak reference. So how can I go about and change this? Well, one of the things I can do is I can, first of all, let's get rid of these references right here. And I can do that by choosing right mouse click, delete reference. Now, since the parent heat exchangers here has a parent-child relationship with these other instances of it, it's not going to delete that element. It's just going to delete that element reference. As you can see, the element remains intact. Same here. I'll go ahead and delete this reference. There we go. I'll go ahead and check this in. And so we're seeing here are our original elements. These elements are still intact. And now I have no element references under line A and B. Now the exercise called, or the example called, for me to establish weak relationships here. So let me go ahead and do that using that mechanism we just saw. I'll choose New Element Reference. I'll go out and browse for what I want, and then I'm going to choose a weak relationship. Now this is going to be under heat exchangers this time. We've removed them from where they were. If You notice they're no longer there. So under heat exchange, we're going to choose heat exchanger A, and we're going to make that a weak reference. There we go. And I'll do the same thing here. New element reference. This is under heat exchangers. And I'll make that a weak reference. We'll go ahead and check this in. And now we have what we want. Let me do a refresh. Yeah, I refreshed because once we removed those elements from before, the icon was going to change the next time I refresh this to show that this is now where the element is and these are element references. And that's not the only way we could have done this. I could have also just used the drag and drop method. Now when you drag and drop, you have a number of different things. You can either copy, move, or create an element reference, depending on whether you're holding down any other keys when you drag and drop. So let me demonstrate. First of all, let me delete these two. We're going to delete the references, not the elements. I'm going to delete these so that we'll have a fresh area to work in here. And see, what I could have done instead of what I had just done by choosing the new element reference, instead of that, I could have just dragged from here over onto line A. Now the default behavior is to create an element reference when you do that. As you can see, it's now prompted me what reference type. I'll go ahead and do a weak reference, and now we've accomplished the same thing. If I drag this, we'll do a weak reference. This is back exactly where we were just a second ago. So we've got now these weak references to the parents right here. And I did that by simply dragging. Now, if you would like to simply move either an element or an element reference, you can do that by holding down Shift. I'll demonstrate by moving this element reference. It's currently under line B. If I hold down Shift key, click, and I'll just go ahead and drag this over here. As you can see, it's going to go ahead and move this. Now, when we move, we still need to specify what the reference is going to be in its new location. I'll go ahead and continue to do that as a weak reference. Yeah, so see, now we've ended up moving these references here. And finally, let's say you wanted to actually copy. If you want to copy one of these objects right here, like let's say I'm going to add a new heat exchanger C. If you hold down Control while you drag, that will go ahead and copy. So I'll do that this way. I'll just hold down Control. I'll drop this right in the same element that it's currently in. And as you can see, what it's done is it's created a brand new instance or a brand new element. It incremented the name so that there's not a duplicate name. I'd go in here and change this, and now that becomes my heat exchanger C. Now that was an example of holding down Control in order to copy that element. So to summarize, if you just drag and drop, you create an element reference. If you hold down the Shift key, you'll move. If you hold down Control, you'll copy. So if you get all that, just go ahead and stop this video. I'm going to go ahead and do what I just learned and use what I just learned to fix this up, make this a little more symmetrical. I don't like this stuff hanging out here. And so let's make this put this back. I need to move this back into line B. Remember, how do I do that? I hold down Shift. So I'm going to hold down Shift, I'll click in this and drag it. I'll go ahead and preserve that weak reference. Yeah, that's back the way I want it. I think I would also like to, well, let's see, we've got a heat exchanger C. Hey, we might as well have a line C as well. So I'd like to copy this line B. How do I copy line B? I should be able to do that by just holding down the Control key. Now it's going to copy that plus everything underneath of it. So hold down Control, click on line B. I'll drag this up underneath area 1. And there we go. It's called line B1. Automatically incremented that. I'll call this line C. And as you can see, it's got that heat exchanger from before because that's simply a copy. Okay, and finally, let's go ahead and replace this with this heat exchanger C. So this is actually a reference. It's a weak reference. So first thing I need to do, let me get rid of heat exchanger B. I'll just delete that. I'm going to delete the reference, though, not the heat exchanger itself. And now I'm going to create a new reference. This is going to be a weak reference to heat exchanger C in line C. How do I create a reference? Well, remember, that's the simple drag and drop. Drag and drop in there is going to prompt me for the reference type. And in this case, I'm going to choose that weak reference. There we go. We check in. Great, everything looks symmetrical, and we did a little bit more of that dragging and dropping.